Hello, vinyl community, and anyone else watching this. I'm back. Sorry, it's been a little while. Just been really busy, work and all that kind of stuff. And I haven't had a lot to show anyway, and I haven't had time to come up with any really good ideas. So, I get home from work, I'm tired, I don't really want to make a video. I'm dragging, you know, so anyway, I'm back. Hope everybody is doing well. I've been watching as many videos as I can. Way behind on my comments. My internet has also been really, really crappy lately. So, I can't get on that much. But whatever. It is what it is. I'm going to be making three videos. First two are going to be recent finds, and I'm also going to do a thrift store video. I wanted to cut them in half, so they're not too long. And all three videos will be featuring this in the background. Of course, the late, great Chuck Berry, gone from us, at least 90 years old. I happen to think he was probably a little older than that. But, I'll say a quick word, what my thoughts on Chuck, and this isn't anything against Elvis. I'm going to compare him to Elvis because Elvis has always been considered the king of rock and roll, and everybody says what they say. And for me, the difference between Elvis and Chuck Berry is when young men of a certain age first saw Elvis, they wanted to learn to play guitar and sing and maybe write songs so that they could look like Elvis and pick up chicks, basically, and just be cool. But when they saw Chuck Berry play for the first time, they wanted to pick up a guitar and learn to play so that they could play rock and roll. And to me, that's the difference between the two. And it's not anything against Elvis. It's just there's a different attitude there. And for me, Chuck Berry has always been the man, and he'll be missed. Anyway, so a couple of days ago, I had a birthday, and I actually had 2 days off of work in a row, which is amazing for me, and it was a Friday and a Saturday. Only the second time, I think, in the 10 years I've been there, I've had a Friday and a Saturday off in a row. So, amazing. So, Friday, I ventured out to go to the brand new record store that's opened in Corning, New York, and the guy was at lunch. And I wasn't going to wait an hour. So, I didn't go. But, and I was going to the next day, Saturday, I planned a road trip for Buffalo to hit the flea market up there, maybe a record store or two. And it was just such a crappy day. It was rainy, but it wasn't really raining, but it was threatening all day. And I'm like, you know what, I'm not going to do that either. So I went to two record stores. I went to the one, I never talk about it very much. It's called Broad Street Records, and it's in Waverly, Pennsylvania. And I went there first because, you know, it was my birthday, and I wanted to treat myself. So, first time I've been to a record store in 6 months. And I went to two in one day. So, here's what I got at the first store, and then I'll tell you what I got at the second store. And then I did stop at a third store, but I don't count that as a record store. Start off with Rutland Times, Eric Idle and Neil Innes, pre, of course, Ruddles stuff. There's two Ruddles albums, I think, and I think this is a scarcer one, but I could be wrong. But they do I Must Be in Love, which wound up on the Ruddles album, but I think this is probably a different version. I'm hoping it's a different version. So anyway, the Ruddles, Eric Idle and Neil Innes, spoofing musically all kinds of things on this record. Then I picked up Motorvatin' by the Henchmen, a Detroit band, fairly recent. Jack White worked with them a little bit in the early days. It's on Norton Records, garage band, very cool. Got it at a decent price, at a really decent price. It was under $10. So, very happy to pick up a Henchmen album, finally have one of these. This I just thought was cool. Dr. Rhino and Mr. Hyde. It's a British import. It's sort of a best of early, a sampler from the early Rhino label. But Rhino doesn't exist in England. So, it's not actually on Rhino Records. It is on Beggar's Banquet Records. So, I thought that was sort of awesome. But these are all Rhino tracks. The Kazoos Brothers and Wildman Fisher. And who else is on here that you might know? The Beetle Rap by the Quarrymen is on here. Fish Heads by Barnes and Barnes. 7 and 7 is Arthur Lee's version. So this will be an interesting spin. And again, it's British import on Beggar's Banquet. So very cool. And I'm into comps more lately than probably ever in my life. So very happy to have that. This story behind why I picked this up. Bill Haley and his Comets, the greatest hits, I don't even know what it's called, just Bill Haley and his Comets, I guess. Golden Hits, 2-record set on Decca or MCA. This one is actually an early MCA copy. They put a sticker on it covering the Decca thing there, although it's in the back with little MCA on the bottom. But the reason I bought this, I have it. Not much to look at on the inside. But I bought it from the same guy before, and one record was on Decca, and one record was on MCA. So, this time when I went back, I checked, this was still there, this was here this time, and one record on Decca, and one record on MCA. So, I'm just going to switch them out, make 2 complete copies, and probably get rid of one at some point in time, probably the MCA one. But, there you go. This just looked very interesting to me. Al Kooper, Al's Big Deal. It's a 2-record set. It's got a little water damage, so it was only $5. And the record's in really nice shape. It's on Columbia, and it's only stamped, but it is a promo copy, and each record is stamped as well. So, $5. Give it a spin. See what Al Kooper was up to at this point in his career. This would be early 70s, I'm guessing. 73, 74. Just a guess. Something like that. Tiny Tim's second album. This again was about $5 cheap. And I picked this up for one reason. I don't know if you'll be able to see the track listing or not. But I have it on 45, but it's beat to death. His version of Great Falls of Fire. Just a hoop. So I had to pick it up. And there's a gatefold. There's a Tiny Tim right there. There you go. Tiny Tim. And Pete Townsend's Iron Man. I don't love this album. I think Pete Townsend didn't really know what to do at this point. But I still think maybe he doesn't know what to do. But I have it on CD. Never had it on vinyl before. And the reason I bought it is right there. John Lee Hooker, I Eat Heavy Metal. In my opinion, best song on this album by far. So, pretty happy about that. I don't think... It does come with... if I can get it out. It does come with a book. I didn't even really look at it. Probably just lyrics. Yeah, just mostly. There are some pictures, but not too many. Lyrics, stuff like that. So again, it was about $5. Cheap enough. And I'm a big Pete Townsend fan, but in this period, I'm not sure what he was doing. But that last 2 album, I'm not sure what they were doing either. So, anyway. This is one of the... Now we're getting into the better finds. The Killer Inside Me, Green on Red. I saw this, and I was like, yes. I haven't heard this album in a long, long time. I don't even remember what it sounds like. But I remember that it was good. And it's funny, because it's an older guy, a little older than me probably, runs the place, and... So, I played this, and this is amazing. And I'm like, yeah, I know. This, I was so, so happy. The Undertones' first album. Yes, finally. I can't believe I found a copy of this in the wild in Sayre, Pennsylvania, of all places. It's probably the only copy in upstate New York. course, Feargal Sharkey in The Undertones. And they were Irish punk pop band. And just awesome. Get Over You and Teenage Kicks. Fantastic stuff. One of my favorites. And probably the best find at that place. And he had no idea who these guys were. He asked me. Modern Vampires in the City, Vampire Weekend. This was $5. Now, it's not meh. Whoever owned this owned a pretty poor turntable, and side two has a few scuffs on it. But for $5, I'll deal with it. Can always upgrade it later, but I was like, holy crap. He asked me who these guys are, and I'm like, oh, they're just an alternative band. I want them to know that this is like a new record, and you know, because could have got a couple more bucks. It's not that bad. So yeah, these last three were my finds at the first store I went, definitely, and I was so pleased to get that. Okay, so now I go up the road about 40 miles, maybe 45 miles to Corning, New York, and there's a brand new record store there, and I promised I'd talk about it to the guy, but I didn't promise I'd be totally positive. It's narrower than this little room I'm in. It goes back a long ways. He sells CDs, records, video tapes, DVDs, and he's going to sell audio equipment. Where he's going to put it all, I have no idea. And he's not into rock and roll at all. I mean, he's into rock, but very limited on like rock and roll and stuff I'm playing right now behind me. Not really anything. And he was a bit pricey. Most of his records were between $7 and $8 and up. So that's a bit pricey, I thought. But I mean, I was there. I'm like, I'm gonna buy a few things from the guy, and I did get a couple of really good deals, I thought. But I don't know. Like I said, he's just a little bit pricey. And he also doesn't have everything priced, and he'll look it up, which we all feel the same about guys that look it up. Hopefully he doesn't know I do a video channel. I didn't tell him that. He knows about my podcast. But anyway, so from this guy at the store is called CD Cafe. If you're in Corning, New York, stop in if you can find it. Like I said, it's about 8 feet wide. But it was alright. I'll go again, but not too soon. Anyway, but I did pick up a couple of good things. I picked up the Stones, It's Only Rock and Roll, still in shrink with the hype sticker. I feel like I'm me, Mr. Mayo. Because I generally like shrink and hype stickers, but I'm not as mad about it as some people. But when I found this, I was like, all right. So Rolling Stones, I don't need to say much about this. It's Only Rock and Roll and shrink with the hype. And want the same thing. Made in the Shade, Rolling Stones, shrink wrap with the hype sticker. So records are really, really nice. If they had inner sleeves, they have them. And he actually put them in another sleeve with the inner sleeve, which was nice. Let me see if this one has an inner. I'm pretty sure it does. Yeah, there's your inner. So everything is intact. Here's your set list. So, you know, I mean, not saying he's outrageous or anything, but, and especially Stones, but Billy Joel's A Stranger would have been $8 as well. And, you know, RL Speedwagon would have been $8. And so a little bit pricey as far as that kind of stuff goes. Those are the only two albums in the normal rock section I bought from him. But I was looking at some of his other stuff, and I found this. And I played a little bit of this and I laughed. Bob McAllister, Wonderama. Includes sing-along lyrics, but this doesn't have the sing-along lyrics, unfortunately. Yes it does, they're on the back. Never mind. If you don't know who Bob McAllister is, people of a certain age that grew up on the East Coast, upstate, up country, New York area especially, so, you know, me and Mr. Mayo, Joe probably knows who Bob McAllister is. Flipside CT Steve has a good chance of knowing who he is. Matt has a good chance of knowing who he is. Did a Sunday morning, I think it was Sunday morning, television show at 10 o'clock on WOR, I think, but it could have been on WPIX, but I'm thinking it was OR. And there's Bob right there. And I watched this when I was a kid every single morning. And then King Kong came on. There was a Sunday morning movie, and for about 2 or 3 years, every single Sunday morning, the Sunday morning movie was King Kong. So I've seen King Kong more than any other movie in my life. But I love this. And this, I chuckled so much. So this was a fine. This was like $5. And it's not minty, but it was really dirty. It's actually plays really, really well. So this may be the find of that store, the CD Cafe. Bob McAllister. I'm keep holding it up, hoping that it's my screenshot. Okay, I got two more. He also has one set of his store is his quote unquote dollar bin, but it's $1 to $5 bin. So it's not that cheap. And this is beat. And he's like, this is Roach. Are you sure you want this? I'm like, yeah. Because it's Deep Groove. It's Capital. I don't have it. It's 98 cents. The Outsiders, Time Won't Let Me. And the album is in really rough shape. But I cleaned it. And I played it. And especially side one. You won't be able to see this. But it's not in any kind of shape. And it is mono, which helps too. And especially side one actually sounded pretty good. So it's good enough for now till I come across, because it's not, you can pick this up for $10 or less, but to me it's not a $10 album. So for a buck, I picked it up. Placeholder for now. And the eyes bulged out of my head, and I tried to be cool, because when you own a record store, you should know what you're doing. Okay? Let me show you the price tag before I even show you the album. There's the price tag. You might get what the album is already. It's George Harrison's Electronic Sound. Now, this isn't mint, but it's VG Plus. And how this record gets VG Plus, I don't know. Who played it a lot? If you don't know, this is George Harrison's Electronic Experiment album. It's his first solo album. It's on Zappel Records. And I have a copy, but my record is probably better than this one, but my cover isn't. This cover is really nice. And again, $2. And he had it in the E section. That's how I know he didn't know what it was. So, there you go. George Harrison, Electronic Sounds, for $2. And my record's over, but I'm not going to do anything about it. And then really quickly, I've been looking on the internet. It came out on Friday. I wanted this album. And believe it or not, the cheapest place I could find it was my local FYE. So I stopped at FYE on the way home from doing everything else. And I picked up the Gin Blossoms New Miserable Experience. And if you can see the price tag, I did not pay for that for it. It was on sale. And I love this album. Hey Jealousy is on here. Just pretty much every song on here is, it's one of the perfect. It's one of the best albums of the 90s, in my opinion, and never saw a vinyl release. Finally has a vinyl release. I couldn't be happier. Gin Blossoms. New Miserable Experience. Picked that up kind of as a birthday present to myself. And that's it. That's video number one. Again, I hope everybody's doing well. I'm way, way behind on my comments, like I always am. Sorry about that. And I have been reading them, though. just haven't had a chance to respond. Check out my podcast, snapcracklepop.podomatic.com. Hope everybody's doing well. And I'll be back with another video shortly. Take care, everybody.